Welcome to this video on creating calendars in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll review how to create a SharePoint calendar to display information about events and dates. We'll review a few list settings that are specific to calendars, and you'll also learn how to overlay calendars so users can see several calendars at once. Let's start by creating a calendar in the Contributor Work Zone site. Click the Settings gear, then Add an App. On the Your Apps page, scroll down until you see Calendar, then click its icon. If you're in a hurry, you can enter a name and click Create. If you do this, the calendar is created and you'll then be on the Site Contents page. However, let's look at the advanced options. Let's name the calendar. Because this name is also used in the address or URL, we should keep the name short and not use spaces or special characters. After we create the calendar, we'll see how to change its name to make it more descriptive. Add a description. NCDOT does not support the option for sharing schedules, so we'll skip that. Click Create to create the calendar. The new calendar appears on its own page. SharePoint considers a calendar to be a list, and events within the calendar are list items. Note that Quick Launch automatically includes the calendar here. However, because it is specifically devoted to dates and times, calendar options are a little different. For example, you'll see that the ribbon has tabs for Events and Calendar. The default view is Calendar and resembles a wall calendar rather than a typical SharePoint list. You'll notice that the views are not listed where you might expect them at the top of the page. So, to see the available calendar views, go to the Calendar tab and click the drop-down under Current View. There are two additional views automatically created in addition to the calendar view that we've seen. The All Events view shows past, present, and future events in a list format. And the Current Events view shows upcoming events only. Let's continue by taking a look at the calendar settings. Click List Settings. This page is where we can change the calendar name to something more readable. Click List Name, Description, and Navigation Settings, change the name to Web Services Calendar, and save the change. Scroll down to see the columns that are automatically created as part of a calendar. Like other lists, the title column is critical. It can be renamed, but it cannot be deleted. And, just like a file's title, an event's title can be used in search results. Here are the three views that are automatically created. The All Events view and the Current Events view have the typical settings you'd expect for a view. For example, if we look at the All Events view, you'll see Name, Columns, Sort, Filter, and the other typical settings. I'll cancel since we were just looking at the settings. If we open up the settings for the calendar view, you'll see some different options: time interval, calendar columns, and default scope. The one you will most likely use is default scope. By default, the calendar view shows a month, but I'll briefly change it to a week here so you can see the difference. And I'll change it back to month for our next example by clicking the Calendar tab, List Settings, and Calendar View. Click OK to store your changes. Note that the calendar name has been changed in the Quick Launch. Finally, let's quickly add a new event to help with the next example. Click the Events tab and New Event. Enter a title of Demo 2 for Calendar Overlays and use the suggested start and end time. Click Save and you'll see the event on the calendar. You can overlay SharePoint calendars so users can view the events from several different calendars in one color-coded calendar. This example shows how to overlay the Web Services calendar we just created on an existing training calendar. Let's go to the training calendar, click the Calendar tab, and click Calendar's Overlay. Click New Calendar to select the calendar you want to overlay. Enter a name for the calendar to overlay. We'll use Web Services Calendar. Make sure the type of calendar is SharePoint. Enter a short description of the Web Services Calendar and use the suggested color of dark teal. The web URL is the address of the SharePoint site that contains the calendar to overlay. In this example, the Web Services Calendar is in the same site as the training calendar, so web URL is already completed. When you click Resolve, SharePoint finds all of the calendars in the site. Click the List drop-down arrow to see all calendars, and click Web Services Calendar. Leave Calendar as the list view. If you want the calendars to always be overlaid, check Always Show. And click OK to finish this overlay. To add up to 10 overlays, follow the same steps to add another new calendar. We'll stop with one overlay and click OK to finish. The training calendar and the web services calendar are both listed in Calendars in View and use different colors to distinguish their events. We overlaid the web services calendar on the training calendar. If we go to the web services calendar, we will see only that calendar because we did not overlay the training calendar on the web services calendar. Like libraries and other lists, there are many more ways to modify calendars for your specific needs. Because the configuration options are so similar for lists and libraries, you'll find it easy to learn more by reviewing other videos on versioning, columns, views, and list and library settings. And, as with any app you've added to a page, you can edit the List View web part to modify a view for that particular page. This video has demonstrated how to create, configure, and overlay SharePoint calendars. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar. Or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.